the second opera of the Atlanta 2010-2011 season, which is George Gershwin's great American opera, Porgy and Bess. It takes place in Charleston, South Carolina, in a black neighborhood. Except for the few spoken parts, all the characters are black. And for reasons both of theatrical authenticity and also to give employment opportunities to African-American singers, Gershwin asked that only black singers be used in singing Porgy and Bess. And to this date, at least in the United States, producers have always honored that request. The thing about using African-American singers in Porgy and Bess is that for some place like Atlanta, it's a real chance for us to show off the incredible talent we have here. And we're very proud that Walter Huff, our chorus master, has put together a Porgy and Bess chorus drawn entirely from people who live here in Atlanta or in the Atlanta area. We're trying to find the next generation of people who are going to be stars in Porgy and Bess. So we have singing Porgy Michael Redding, who actually is from Clayton County. He just sang his first performances of it in Virginia, and he's really fantastic in the part. The voice is everything you could want. He's completely believable theatrically, and we're really excited to be presenting someone who's really a hometown singer here in the starring part. We have Laquita Mitchell singing Bess. Laquita is an established singer at all sorts of opera houses around the world. When we did Porgy and Bess in Paris in 2008, she sang the role of Clara. This time she'll be singing Bess, who of course is the lead part. She did it in San Francisco last season, and she'll just be fantastic in it. We can't wait. We're doing a new production of Porgy and Bess that is building new sets that are going to use video projections in an especially interesting and theatrically compelling way. What we've built in conjunction with the University of Kentucky Opera Theater and the Viz Center at the University of Kentucky are these two screen units that are 16 by 20, and there are a bunch of small projectors behind them on scaffolding. And the great thing about this is that it will enable us to have very interesting video footage running constantly that will coordinate with the stage action, not detract from it. But at the same time, the screen unit is small enough that we can have physical set units in front of it. And so what we hope to do with this is get all the advantages of a traditional hard physical operatic set with all the advantages of video projections. Especially for an opera like Porgy that has so many big crowd scenes, when there's a lot of interesting stuff going on stage, you want to have as much room as possible for the singers to do their thing. And we think this technology will allow us to do that while at the same time doing some really cool things with film footage. We engaged Larry Marshall to direct the show. When he was a singer doing Sportin' Life, he sang, I don't know, hundreds of performances of the parts. He knows the opera Porgy and Bess better than almost anyone. We'll get a great show that is faithful to all the traditions of Porgy and Bess that we want, and Larry is thrilled about the video projections. We're shooting some of them in the Carolinas. We found beaches that are a lot like Kittiwa Island. Richard Kagey, the set designer for the show, is going to be shooting the footage, and he found this beach in North Carolina that's just perfect. For the hurricane scene, we're also in touch with the Weather Channel to get actual storm footage that we hope to incorporate into this. So it could be pretty exciting. Once on, we are conducting Porgy and Bess, Keith Lockhart, who's the music director of Boston Pops. For a piece that successfully bridges the classical popular divide, Keith Lockhart is a really appropriate choice. Opera offers things that other art forms or other forms of entertainment or other forms of theater just don't. It's got obviously singing and music and dance and visual elements and interesting lighting and literature and acting. And what that means is that there's something in it for everyone. I mean, whatever aspect of it appeals to you, you'll find something there, and then you'll also enjoy the rest of it.